The Skoda Kodiaq hits the ball out of the recreation center. However, the 140 TDI asks a 6,000 premium that exclusive stacks up if your way of life requests the additional snort and fuel-sparing advantages. Idiosyncratic Czech automaker Skoda is one of those brands that frequently tends to slip off the radar for more than a couple of new auto purchasers, however bounce into a Skoda Kodiaq out of the blue, and we ensure you'll have a newly discovered thankfulness for the brand. There isn't generally any one perspective that stands on another, however as an entire bundle this 7-situate all-wheel drive stack lugger with clean European styling, a huge amount of tech, and a sensible sticker price is a truly convincing bundle in what is a fiercely aggressive section. Some will be taken by the Kodiaq's oddity highlights, for example, the covertly reserved umbrellas in the front entryways, or the separately bundled cashmere delicate covers covered up under the boot floor, all altogether advantageous highlights and completely certifiable tried by this analyst. Others will warm to its mind-boggling reasonableness, solace, and general all-round livability of this nearly expansive SUV with an identification that has been around for over a century. Along these lines, any reasonable person would agree they've had a lot of training. One of the Kodiaq's most valuable highlights, however, are the entryway defenders that consequently fly out when said entryways are opened, while conveniently withdrawing when closed. They ensure both your vehicle and those stopped beside you in space-starved strip mall car parks. Measure astute, the new Skoda successfully conquers any hindrance between average size and extensive SUV significance at 4,697 mm long. It's 104 mm short of Volkswagen's Touareg, destined to be supplanted, yet 265 millimeters longer than the Tiguan. Skoda propelled the Kodiaq back in August 2017 with only one variation, the 132 TSI, a 2.0-liter turbo 4 petroleum making 132 kilowatts and 320 Nm of torque. The diesel rendition we've tried here dropped a couple of months after the fact, wearing a 140 TDI identification with 140 kilowatts and 400 Nm, promising better efficiency, 5.9L/100 km/V 7.6L/100 km, and a 6,000 premium to boot, $48,990, in addition to on streets. Wherever you peer, all around, is an element fest. The tow bar, for example, essentially flies out at the tap of a catch in the boot, however it must be said it just has a 80 kg most extreme downball weight notwithstanding a 2,000 kg tow limit. What's more, similar to the extravagant covers, the load days hides beyond anyone's ability to see and bother free under the boot floor over the space saver. There's even a coordinated lead burn in the gear and a few freight nets for securing different less steady merchandise in the back. All the lodge lights are LEDs and the glove box has a chill work and additionally a lot of room. There are even backseat warmers for the two detachable seats, and a large group of different highlights on the off chance that you select the discretionary tech and luxury packs as our analyzer was outfitted with. There's a lot of the well done in advance as well, similar to the expansive midway situated glass outline infotainment screen, with the lucidity and profundity of shading coordinated just by the most recent age OLED TVs. It's additionally got a swipe work like your cell phone, an Apple CarPlay and Android Auto for extreme simplicity and nature. Baffling, however, is the solitary USB port in advance, unless obviously they're astoundingly well covered up, yet that is whatever we could discover. With the goal that's none for the back slows down. Not all that shrewd, at that point. The one comfort to this oversight is the arrangement of telephone/tablet holders behind the back seats, however you'll have to supply two or three versatile battery packs to control. The punctured calfskin seats are extremely very exceptional for their solace and support, just like the level base sewed cowhide wheel that feels more Audi than VW. The dash itself is a superbly basic format with negligible handles and catches, and a lot of delicate touch plastics. The hard stuff is beneath knee level and for the most part beyond anyone's ability to see, in all the correct parts. So, we could manage without the terribly designed dark trim bits decorating the glove box sash and entryways in this specific case. You must ponder what they were considering. Unfortunately, there's no VW-style full-fest computerized instrument show, rather settling on a couple of customary simple dials split by an advanced data show finish with speed measure. It's a substantial unit, however, and simple to peruse initially. There are more open 7-situate SUVs, similar to the bigger Mazda CX-9, yet the Skoda is keenly intended to give super measure gear space. That is 630L behind the second column and an incredible 2005L when collapsed level. Indeed, even with travelers in the third line, there's as yet 270L behind line, at least three than enough for the week-by-week shopping for food pull. Traveler space is not too bad as well, in everything except the third push seating. Mind you, the center seat in the second column is perceptibly traded off because of its absence of width, harder padding, and forcing transmission burrow bump. Additionally, back in push three things get considerably more tightly, however in any event they're adequately wide notwithstanding for a grown-up, not that we'd ever suggest it however. Get in the driver's seat of the Kodiak and the driving background is equivalent with whatever remains of the vehicle, in other words great. Yet, in spite of making significantly more torque than its oil proportional, the diesel can't coordinate it for off-the-line pace, as there's basically more slack with this motor. In any case, it isn't a long ways behind either, requiring 8.5 seconds to hit 100 km per hour to the oil adaptation's 8.2 seconds. By method for correlation, the all the more intense and comparatively measured Land Rover Discovery Sport SD4 SE needs 8.9 seconds, while the littler Volkswagen Tiguan 110 TDI with indistinguishable power and torque yields is slower still at 9.3 seconds. In any case, at no time through the span of the week's driving did I feel the requirement for any more pace in the 140 TDI. All things considered, the 140 TDI pulls pleasantly from abject in the rev range, and it continues pulling while at the same time easily handling the steepest slopes Sydney can toss at it. The uplifting news is it never feels like it's working all that hard either. Motor commotion is genuinely very much quieted as well, even under max stack, however there's no mixing up this donk for anything besides an oil burner. Paired with the standard 7-velocity DSG twin take hold of transmission nevertheless makes for a very comfy pressure inside the Kodiak. In fact, it feels like a higher marriage than with the petrol engine in phrases of a smooth-moving driveline made for lengthy distance cruising at the motorway, but plenty extra than enough cross for day-by-day obligations in suburbia. Our tester become also equipped with Skoda's Adaptive Dynamic Chassis Control, DCC, that makes use of electric valves to manipulate the movements of the shock absorbers, and to excellent effect too. It's every other motive again to tick the tech PC choice, which additionally adds a couple of power modes with various damper settings. My colleague Mike Costello previously reviewed the 132 TSI and mentioned a barely firm ride. Well, we can assure you that the adaptive dampers completely get rid of any harshness inside the journey, at least in comfort. Body manage robotically tightens up in sport for more dynamic using conditions. It is probably a proper family size SUV, but the Kodiak is likewise fun to pressure, particularly due to said frame manage and the remarks via the steering wheel. All the pedals sense good too strong and revolutionary pressures. It's only an absolutely excellent car to power with the brought gain of 4x4 traction and grip for those awful weather days. Adding those optionally available packs we referred to earlier also offers you all of the cutting-edge energetic safety systems, like lane assist and aspect assist with blind spot detection, surround view camera for smooth parking, visitors jam help, emergency assist, and rear sight visitors alert. There's even auto park help and maneuver braking help, in conjunction with an off-street pressure mode that makes using off the overwhelmed music a lot easier and much less worrying. It's great to realize there are ECU car makers out there willing to back their product with extended warranties, and Skoda is one of those presenting 5-year/limitless-kilometer piece of thoughts. Even the capped price provider packs are truthful, with buyers able to pick between 3-year/45,000 km and 5-12-month/75,000 km intervals for $1,399 and $2,999 respectively. We just like the solid torque curve of the diesel Kodiak. It makes sense if you're doing masses of Ks as part of your everyday commute or need to tow a jet ski or such. However, we're less captivated with the 6 grand feet top class over the petrol version. And, frankly, we're not certain that it stacks up until your way of life desires demand it.